morning. How is everyone today? Thank you very much for being here, and welcome to IBC. My name is Jason Druss. I'm a product marketing manager here at Adobe.
And my name is Joey Chery-Valentin. I'm a mid-market account executive here at Frame.io with Adobe.
So what we're going to do today is take a look at a particular use case in post-production by showing you the Frame.io panel inside of Premiere Pro and After Effects, and we're going to show you how a strong feedback loop can help scale your video production. What we have here is a basketball commercial, a 15-second spot for a new brand, and this spot actually needs to go to broadcast in less than 1 hour. The edit has been approved. What we need to work on today is color correction and our finished motion graphics workflow. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to go ahead and upload this draft one and see what Joey thinks of our first color pass. Now, the cool thing about this is I don't need to export my project from Premiere and then separately go to a web browser, find that file, and upload it to the web. I can do all of that right from inside of Premiere Pro. So we're going to choose to upload our active sequence, and we're going to call this B-Ball V1. We're going to choose to export this in 1080. I want to export the whole sequence, although I do have the option of selecting an in and out point or specific work areas that I want to upload. I'm going to go ahead and upload this file. And the cool thing about this is that it all happens automatically in one step. It is not just that the file is uploaded, it's uploaded and organized in a clean bin for my collaborators to be able to find.
Like you guys just saw, Jason was able to upload that asset from the Premiere Pro panel inside of Frame.io, and here in my Safari web browser, I'm actually able to go ahead and access this asset. What I can do here is go ahead and scroll through this timeline and check out the footage. And I'm liking this spot a lot. It's pretty clean. The color's a little flat, though. I think it could be a little bit more dynamic. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to tag Jason, and I'm going to say, hey, Jason, let's make this a little more moody.
So if anyone wants to see this, I actually just got a notification on my watch that a comment was left on the video that we just uploaded through Premiere Pro. We can see right here, there's a comment waiting for me on this asset. So we're going to go ahead and click on it. And here's the note that Joey just left. And notice when I hopped to that comment, it jumped to the same exact timecode accurate frame on my Premiere Pro sequence. Now, not only can I view comments in Frame.io, I can respond to comments. We can have entire conversations within my creative app. So I'm actually going to go to my comment view here to have a little bit more room to take in the note and reply. So what I'm going to go ahead is like that. I'm going to reply, and I'm going to say, no problem. V2 is coming soon. The first thing I'm gonna do here is try a nice cool steel blue color temperature. Let's add a little bit of tint. And it's looking a little aquamarine to me. So let's try going in the opposite direction. Let's try going green tint, warm color temperature, and something like that. And let's hop back to the Frame.io panel. Time to upload our V2. Let's go back to our regular viewer. Upload, active sequence. This time, I'm going to make sure auto version is selected. This is one of my favorite tools in all of Frame.io. It has saved me way more than once. So let's go ahead and upload. What auto version does is it makes sure that our versions are stacked on top of one another. So you can keep the same review link, the same presentation link, send the same exact asset, and you know that your client is always going to view the newest version because it clearly says V2 right on top of the asset.
So you can see on my screen that Jason was able to get that new color pass into Frame.io. And now you can see on the asset, there's this V2 here. So I can dive into the asset. And what I'm going to do is actually compare that first version to this new version. So I'm going to scrub through the timeline, take a look. And wow, Jason, you did a great job. It's looking much more moody, gritty, a bit warmer. It's popping. So I really like that. I'm going to go ahead and tell him that this looks great. And while Jason was working on that color pass, I was actually able to dive into After Effects here and animate some text really quickly for that last shot. And while he was working in Premiere, I was able to utilize the Frame.io panel inside of After Effects, which works in much the same way, to upload this new shot into the VFX folder.
So I'm going to quickly go to the folder that Joey uploaded our comp to. Let's hop over to VFX. And there's the shot. I can click on it right here, and I can see, here's his comment. Jason Druss, please take a look at this comp, please. More than happy to. Love it. Dig it. It's great. So I can click on my item options, scroll down here, and select import file. I can import it as 1920 by 1080. I'm going to choose to save it to my desktop, and it's going to download very quickly. And look at that. It imported directly into my bin without me having to do anything. And let's take a look. What we ended up having here today was a complete color, finishing, and motion graphics workflow on a spot, getting something to broadcast in less than an hour to make time. And we were able to complete all of this work without ever leaving our creative apps of choice, because we kept a very tight, strong, and closed feedback loop that squeezed every drop of productivity we had in the short amount of time that we had to finish the project. All right, so we're going to hang out and come around with any questions, but thank you very much for spending time with us this morning. We
thank
really appreciate
all.
It.
Appreciate it.